Michael Aubertin was a multi-talented individual involved in several aspects of the arts and culture of St. Lucia. He contributed to the development of arts and culture not only from the perspective of being the director of culture for several years, but as a practicing artist. And this is how he was eulogized by his loved ones.
Mike and I have been friends for the past 60 years. And the time that we have lived and shared together can and will never end. We were inseparable. I mean, from morning till night. And when it was time for us to sleep, Mike never slept to dream, but he dreamed to change his world, the community, and our friendship.
His three children, who inherited his talents, paid tribute to him with performance of song and dance.
Reincarnation, flowers for a soul for before the fruit come. Reincarnation.
City, you, so we gon' walk it out. Move mountains. We gon' walk it out and move mountains. And I'll rise up, I'll rise like the day. I'll rise unafraid, I'll rise up. And I
You raised me up so I could stand the mountains. You raised me up to walk on stormy seas. I'm strong and I'm on your shoulders. You raised me up to more than I can be.
Aubertin was an accomplished singer, songwriter, and calypsonian. Singing under the name Mighty Mighty, he won the first Independence Calypso competition in 1979. Many will recall his hit song, Making Bread on the Dead.
As I turn around in my nice coffin, I wish I was not Anglican. Picture flicks and never we have a dead post union. The tractor digging, man it pushing, Brad and Bram, all the graves falling. If I was a zombie, I'd push up me bony hand. Help us sing it. They got no shame, they should be blamed. Making, got no respect, I do object. I tell you them fellas pray.
Aubertin also dabbled in writing. He was a fiction writer, screenwriter, and playwright. His short story Calypso Finals won a BBC Caribbean Magazine Prize in 1977 and was broadcast by them. In 1978, his collection of short stories entitled Mighty Laughs was published. He was interviewed by the BBC in relation to his historical novel Negmawon, Freedom Fighter, published in 2000, which addresses slavery and oppression as well as gender issues. He also wrote and directed a film based on this novel. Aubertin was very involved in the Roman Catholic Church in counseling and teaching with his wife, Rose Aubertin. He also worked for many years with the Catholic Television Broadcasting Service.
When we had a Valentine's concert 2 years ago, we chose Mike and Rose as a symbol of love, a symbol of love. And it is so fitting because Mike and Rose, for us, represent what Eucharist is all about. The love they had from 16 years, for 49 years, the love they shared with the society, with the young people, the love of country and service to country, but more specifically, the Eucharistic love that Rose showed during those years of nursing Mike, giving of her own self, even while she herself was an oblation.
Michael Aubertin passed away at his Entrepot home on August 18, 2020. He was 72 years old. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.